Hello students, this is fifth and last part of our third poem To the Autumn, which is written by John Keats. So page number 59, on this page number second paragraph. Now listen carefully. Keats says that the music of spring, so what is spring? Is regarded as a sweet. Regarded means to look at or consider. Keats says that the music of spring is regarded as sweet. So according to the Keats, the music in the spring season that is regarded, look at or consider very sweet. He asked the people not to think about that music, and he is requesting people that don't think about the music which we can hear in spring season. The autumn has got its music, and particularly autumn season also have his own music. In that particular season you can see or you can heard some particular kind of music. In the autumnal evening people can see red cloud with strips. Strip it means a long narrow mark. Strip, and they are giving their colors to the harvested field. So in autumn evening you can see a narrow strip or mark in the cloud, in the red cloud in the sky, and those red clouds are giving their colors to the harvested field. The harvested field, it means that area which is completely ripen and the crops taken out from that field, from that farm. In such an atmosphere the mournful singing, mournful it means sad or sorrowful. Singing of the birds, gnats, it means small biting flies. Can be heard. So in this season we can see, we can hear very sad singing sound of gnats. Gnats, it means a small insect which bites us, for example mosquito, from the family of mosquito. The willow, it means a kind of tree which tiny easily bend branches. The willow tree are going down in the river according to the movement of the wind. So particular willow tree, it is a very elastic or easily bendable branches had, and those branches easily can move downward with the flow of air or wind. In these trees one can hear the bleating sound. Bleating, it means cry of sheep. Bleating sound of the lamb. Lamb means young Shiv. A small baby of Shiv. So in this sound, you can clearly hear the sound of lamb that is crying in that air. Why? On the boundary of the hill. Because that lamb, that small, younger baby of Shiv is on the edge, on the corner of that hill, and he is afraid in there. Therefore, that lamb is crying loudly, and you can hear that lamb's voice clearly in that atmosphere, in those other sounds also. The red breast, it means red chest of any bird. Bird is whistling in shrill voice. Shrill, it means sharp. In the field. So there is a bird which is having red chest, and that bird is whistling with a very sharp voice in that field, in that farm. At the same time, swallow. A small bird with four are also chirping. Chirp, it means a sharp note of a bird. So there is a swallow, a small bird, and that is also making a sharp, shrill noise in that atmosphere, and that bird, that small bird, is flying in the sky, and there he is making lot of noise, and that noise is very sharp, very shrill. So in this way, this fifth part of the third poem ends here, and in this way this poem also ends here. So have a good day to all of you. Thank you very much.